Good day, I'm Samantha Allen, and this is your GIS News for November 15. The central bank says it has enough international reserves to cover 14.1 weeks of goods and service imports, more than the international benchmark of 12 weeks. Bank of Jamaica Governor Brian Winter made the announcement earlier this week. He told reporters that measures to temper a 1.4% decline in the selling rate of the Jamaican dollar against its U.S. counterpart, attributed to the NIR's decline to $1.3 billion at the end of the September quarter. But at Wednesday's briefing, Mr. Winter said the stock of gross reserves was at $1.98 billion.
By any measure and anybody's measure, this is more than ample. And I can tell you, sitting where I'm sitting, I don't have a problem as the governor of the central bank of resources to use for appropriate intervention and actions.
Cabinet has given its approval to the White Paper on Tax Reform, paving the way for it to be tabled in Parliament next week. The Green Paper on Tax Reform was brought to Gordon House in May of last year. A subcommittee of Parliament was subsequently convened to facilitate public consultation on the document. That process concluded in April this year when the committee presented its report on the consultations.
The White Paper does not specify rates, but sets out the basic policy position that will guide the reform process.
The Jamaica Constabulary Force has begun deploying more officers to patrol communities and commercial districts in anticipation of heightened activities leading up to the Christmas holidays. Deputy Commissioner of Police Glenmore Hines says this started last weekend, and the numbers will be increased as the holiday period draws nearer.
The 19 geographic divisions will be adding an approximate 500 members for patrol duties, and this is island-wide.
In addition, he says the 202 student constables who graduated last Friday will also be deployed into the field. DCP Hines says most officers will be policing bus parks, major thoroughfares, and the commercial districts. At the same time, he's encouraging citizens to quickly report illicit activities to help the police execute their duties. The Kingston and St. Andrew Corporation, KSAC, is also revealing its plans for safety and other vending issues for the holidays. On Tuesday, the KSAC passed a resolution that lays out the approved vending areas in downtown Kingston. The designated vending zones include areas of New Chapel Lane, Peachon Street, West Street, Princess Street, Luke Lane, Matthews Lane, Haywood Street, and Beckford Street. Mayor Angela Brown-Burke says the KSAC will also be making the area bounded by Peachon, Beckford, West, and Barry Streets, known as Open Market, available for additional vending spaces and parking where necessary. She also revealed that discussions were being finalized with a major corporate sponsor to host another shopping fest at St. William Grand Park from December 12 to 15. The mayor gave a commitment that this year's Christmas shopping experience in the market districts would be the best ever.
We have a responsibility to provide a safe and orderly environment for business downtown. We are, however, committed to doing so with respect.
In an effort to reduce the number of preteens and teenagers engaged in substance abuse, the National Council for Drug Abuse is focusing its activities for Drug Awareness Month on this segment of the population. On November 28, the NCDA will be hosting a parent training seminar in St. James, as poor parenting is cited as one of the risk factors for substance abuse among the young. Executive Director of the Council, Michael Tucker, explains the rationale, saying research shows that there is significant experimentation with substances among children at an earlier age.
70% of the young people in the school population have used alcohol. About 80% of them had their first drink before age 14. This is 35% of them have been drunk on one or more occasions. And we're now talking about 13 to 15 year olds.
Mr. Tucker was speaking at a GIS think tank session recently. And finally, developing a standard regional framework for geographic spatial information is one of the many areas of focus for the 6th Caribbean EURESA GIS Conference. About 200 geographic information system GIS professionals from across the region are currently in the island participating in the conference that wraps up on Friday at the Hilton Rosall Hotel. Speaking ahead of the conference, President of the Caribbean Chapter of EURESA, Valerie Grant, outlined the importance of a forum to share critical information on the use of GIS technology for development planning.
Most of the more enduring problems that we face, poverty alleviation, disaster risk reduction, all of these things have a spatial component with it, and GIS is what helps us to solve these problems.
And that's it for GIS News today. I'm Samantha Allen. Thanks for watching.